let's learn about autonomic nervous system drugs that affect the parasympathetic nervous system. The parasympathetic nervous system promotes the rest and digest response. Parasympathetic drugs will either stimulate or inhibit the parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathomimetics, or parasympathetic agonists, mimic the effects of the parasympathetic nervous system. These drugs promote the rest and digest response. There are two types of parasympathetic receptors. Both are cholinergic and include muscarinic and nicotinic receptors. Postganglionic parasympathetic neurons secrete acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is broken down by the enzyme acetylcholinesterase. An example of a direct-acting parasympathetic agonist is bethanacol, which binds directly to cholinergic receptors and promotes the rest and digest response. Bethanacol resists breakdown by acetylcholinesterase. Bethanacol is also moderately selective to muscarinic receptors, so it can be called a muscarinic agonist. Remember that acetylcholine is broken down by acetylcholinesterase. Indirect acting parasympathomimetics inhibit acetylcholinesterase. Examples of these drugs include neostigmine, physostigmine, pyridostigmine, edrafonium, and donepezil. These drugs are used to treat myasthenia gravis, Alzheimer's disease, glaucoma, and for stimulating smooth muscle contractions in the bowel. Acetylcholine-blocking drugs have several names, including cholinergic antagonists, cholinergic blockers, anticholinergics, and parasympatholytics. These drugs work by attaching to cholinergic receptors and blocking the effects of acetylcholine. Parasympathetic activity is blocked, resulting in more sympathetic activity. Examples of these drugs include atropine, scopolamine, benztropine, ipratropium, and trihexylphenidyl. These drugs are used in GI disorders, eye procedures, bradycardia, pre-anesthesia, asthma, and overactive bladder. I hope you have learned something about parasympathetic drugs, and see you next time.